Hi, this tutorial is on using the timeline, which is this function up here in ProPresenter. Today we have a song by Paul Balazs called My Reward. And what is required is you need an MP3 or an audio version of this song, and you can sync these slides up to automatically change to the song. So thing that I use and helps that I find is to use the arrangements tool, which we have a tutorial on that if you need to look at that to refresh on how to make up arrangements if you're not doing that already. I make an arrangement here called With Music, and this is the sequence in which Paul Balazs sings the song. Verse 1, chorus, then a blank is for instrumentals. Then he does verse 1 chorus, then he does the bridge, and then another bit of an instrumental, and so on. And find this easy because then it sequences the slides in the right order, and I can just click through it, and it goes a lot easier. It's not necessary, but it's sure helpful. So let's get on with this. We'll open up the timeline here, which we will then attach an audio file to. And when we click on these particular slides, you will see them starting to show up here. And all that is just telling ProPresenter when to trigger and to what slide. So we'll start off by adding an audio track, new audio track, and open up as My Reward. Select that. And because I've already done this once before, I just do right over. And here's the track. So if you hit the play, you can hear that. That's the play button. This is going back to the beginning, which is you can always see by it puts the title in over here. So this would be the introduction. And this is the record button. So we'll just trigger it back, push it back, the playhead back to the beginning, and start going. I normally click on the group slide or the background slide in order to start it up. So here we go. We'll hit record, hit play, just click on this side. Now one doesn't have to be right on, but the closer you are, the better, the less tweaking afterwards. But it's not totally necessary. You can always go back and change those things. So there's this first one.
Say, good and faithful servant. I want to hear you say, I've prepared a place for you. Let all the treasures of this world fade away.
And you'll see I trigger the slides, tend to want to trigger them a little early, so people have a chance to see the words before they all of a sudden have to start singing them. That normally makes it a little easier in the live presentation.
Jesus, you are my reward. To see your face on that day is all I'm living.
And it's coming up to an instrumental, and I'll just go to a blank slide for that. See on that. And again, you know, if you're pretty particular about hitting it on the beats and so on, we will come back and readjust those. But it doesn't have to be that precise.
Well done. I want to hear you say, good and faithful servant. I want to hear you say, I've prepared a place for you. Lord, let all the treasures of this world fade away. Jesus, you are my reward. To hear your voice on that day is all I'm living for.
So now it goes into a bit of an instrumental. So I tend to go to a blank background slide only. See, that one was a bit slow. So we'll come back and re-edit that guy. And of course, one can go over and over and practice it and so on. That's the nice thing about it. And once it's in there and it's good, you know, it's like a CD. It's always recorded. It's always triggered at the right times. Do the last fade out. Okay, so we can pause this here because that he just fades out. So here we are, we've got the whole track lined up here. First off, we know we want to move this guy all the way to the beginning here and push the playhead to the beginning, and we can just watch how we do it. Normally I will hit save at this end just to make sure that I don't have to go back again in case something happens. So here we go. Okay, let's just clear all and we can see how that first slide comes in. And it's not necessary to listen to it all the way through. You can just go just before the edits. Okay, so we heard that was a little slow, so we go back, and what I normally do is go back a little bit here, click on the previous slide. Our record button is not on, so it's not going to record a triggering there, so that's just so that I can see the slide prior to it. And here we come in. Okay. And now we don't have to play it all the way in real time. We can just go up to just before that and fade away. Okay, so that one is a little ahead of it. So go back here. Clicking on the slide that was prior to it. That's another reason why I have these in a proper arrangement, so that it's as the CD plays it. Makes it a whole lot easier. Fade away, Jesus. Okay. Again, we can just fast forward to here. Yeah, I might push that a little early. Just go back to that. Okay, and I'm going to move that. Whoops. See, I had that highlighted, so that's why that one moved. I need to click on the one that I want to adjust and move it up. So let's just make sure this guy is still correct. Okay, that looked all right. Okay, I would push that a little earlier, because again, like we said, we want the words to come up. Okay, and now we move on down the timeline. So as you can see, this becomes quicker as you get used to it. Okay, that one's good. Okay, that one's good. See you face to face. Okay, instrumental. Okay, that one came out a little, so go back. Okay, click on the blank. Down the line. Okay, this one I was a little sleeping there a little bit. Okay, so let's just get that slide up so I can read the words. Okay. Move that there. Okay, I'd move that a little further forward so people can, you know that we're repeating that again. There you go. Much better. And then we know that end one is just the fade out to the blank slide. Okay. And always remember, that's orange, Command S will save it. So that is by and large all that we have. You can adjust the speed of the song, speed it up if you want to when you're recording it, and you know that can give you quicker time, especially if it's a song you really know. You can also offset this. So remember that any of these effects that one uses will and the time of your dissolves or special effects will affect when you need to trigger. So these are triggered for like a 1 second dissolve. If you are doing it longer than that, any effect, some of those moving in and moving out ones, you might want to adjust this. But you can always adjust it by the offset. Negative, it makes it trigger earlier. Positive makes it trigger a little later. So that all said and done, that is how these songs go. The other thing that I normally do is I will give it a different category, just so that I know that some of our songs have music to them, some don't. If it doesn't, it's called a song. If it does, I put a category called with music, and that is easily done in the preferences. You go to the labels, and I just created one called with music, and just give it, just by right clicking on here, go to category and choose with music, and that way it's an easy way to sort. You can just pull up those if you want, or by titles. So if we have two songs, we got Time to Worship is another song that we can bring in here. So these times in there, let's see, let's remove these from playlist. Made to Worship, My Reward. Oops, there we go. It's a little slow here with the recording going on. So all you need to do is come up to timeline, hit play, and that goes. Let's see. Let's go to near the end. Okay, it's not triggering because I'm still on a slide here. So now it's gone to a blank slide. And if we go to the next one. So it's triggering it, and you can just have them in your playlist here, and that should work pretty well. Hope this was helpful, and there's obviously a whole lot of ways you can use this very useful tool. Nice thing is that those stay with it. One can go and make different arrangements and still trigger them manually by going through this. It doesn't, by having that audio file in, doesn't mess with the song in the database at all. Again, I would highly suggest learning how to do arrangements and choosing that as the arrangement with music would make it a whole lot easier, especially if you're doing a mixture between having the music with music and without. Thank you.